Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Hey, good afternoon. Thank you. Say it back to me. Good afternoon. That's right. Good afternoon. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We are all gathered here for this wonderful occasion. Now we need you to take your seats, find a nice quiet space, because we're going to get started. And the mayor-elect has said she wants everything done decently and in order and expeditiously. So we're going to need you all to keep your voices down so we can get moving. Josh Freeman is going to come here in just a moment, and then we'll be off and running. And another place I would say amen. I'm not going to say it here, but you got the drift, right? Yeah. There you go. Good afternoon. As we prepare to receive the mayor, we're going to ask that if you have phones, would you please turn those off so that we can have a nice, succinct, orderly meeting. The president of the city council, Mr. Josh Freeman, should be coming in very shortly, after which we want to receive the mayor-elect. Where is Josh in the room? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, good to see you both. I see him in the back. City Councilman, please come on in. Thank you so very much. Okay. President of the City Council, Mr. Josh Freeman.
Good afternoon. I would like to call this swearing-in ceremony to order and introduce you, Mr. Larry Moon, our Master of Ceremonies today.
Thank you so much. Again, if you would prepare yourselves, for the entry of the mayor of the city of Flint, Dr. Karen Williams Weaver. You can clap some more. You can clap some more. Amen. That's right. Thank you so very much. Which, if you would please, we will ask that the Flint police will please post the colors. Thank you. Thank you so much. We still want you to stand just one more moment. Thank you, City of Flint police officers. Now we will have the Pledge of Allegiance. Flint Community Schools students, Regina DeLoach, Colin Edwards, accompanied by Mr. Warren Jackson. Pledge of Allegiance, if you will.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and liberty and justice for all.
Thank you so much. You may be seated. We will now have a selection by Mr. Lennox Burroughs, God Bless America. Lennox.
God bless America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Outstanding job, Lennox. Outstanding job. Yeah, he can sing anywhere, yeah? Anywhere. As we prepare to move on with the program, I'm going to push this program because the mayor called me and talked real mean to me and said how much time she wanted to be in here. So if I push it too much, it's her fault. But let's keep moving. At this time, what we're going to do now, I would like for the department heads of the for the city of Flint who are sitting on the front row to please stand, turn and face the people. People, give them a round of applause for the hard work they do for a little money. Please stand. Thank you very much. They are so deserving, and we would like for our city council to please stand. We certainly want all other elected officials who are out in the audience to please stand, even those old ones who used to be. Please stand. Those are true laborers of love. At this time, we're going to call for the invocation. I got two or three preachers on here now. Preachers, I'm pushing y'all too, okay? I got invocation by the Reverend Dan Scheid, rector of the St. Paul Episcopal Church, to be followed by scripture from the Reverend Pastor Wallace Hill III of the Mount Pisgah Missionary Baptist Church. You'll come in that order. Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy and loving God, in your word you have given us a vision of that holy city to which the nations of the world bring their glory. Behold and visit, we pray, the cities of the earth, especially our city of Flint and this gathering today. Send down upon our mayor-elect, Dr. Karen Weaver, the spirit of wisdom, charity, and justice, that with steadfast purpose she may faithfully serve in her office to promote the well-being of all people. Renew the ties of mutual regard which form our civic life. Enable us to eliminate poverty, prejudice, and oppression, so peace may prevail with righteousness and justice with order. And so people from different cultures and with differing talents may find with one another the fulfillment of their common humanity. All this we ask with humble thanks and joyful expectation. Amen. Amen.
From the prophet Jeremiah chapter 29, four verses beginning with verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, and when ye shall search for me with all your heart, and I will be found of you, saith the Lord, and I will turn away your captivity. I will gather you from all the nations, from all the places whither I have driven you, saith the Lord, and I will bring you again into the place whence I caused you to be carried away captive. God bless you.
Certainly, we want to thank the rector, Pastor Scheid, and also Pastor Hill. We will now be prepared for the occasion, which will be Dr. Jesse Meldrew, who will be followed by Joanne Carrington, a well-known songstress and former Flint police officer. Now, she can sing and walk all over this house, but she's not going to do it today. Amen. This time. Dr. Muldrew, and followed by Sister Carrington.
Now, you know, somebody said that it couldn't be done, but Dr. Weaver, with a chuckle, replied, maybe it couldn't. But she wouldn't be one to say so until she tried. So she buckled right in with the trace of a grin on her face. And if she worried, she hid it. She started to sing and tackle the thing that couldn't be done. And she did it. Dr. Weaver, we celebrate your courage, your strength, your fortitude, and the boldness with which you have undertaken this task. We come to honor you for being the first, a two-time first. Not surprising, however, because you have an ancestry of first. Number one, your father, Dr. T. Wendell Williams, who was my children's pediatrician, was the first African-American elected to the Board of Education for Flint Community Schools. And then your mother, Marion Coates Williams, was the first classroom teacher hired by the Flint Community Schools. So, of course, we're not surprised that you too are a first. Dr. Weaver, we salute you for having shown by example that great things can be done and great obstacles overcome. Will you stand, please? Turn around, face your audience. Now, thank you, and we must get back to task. I have my marching orders from the good doctor here who told us what we had to do. So I am going to get right into this. First of all, to the elected officials, the dignitaries, the clergy, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, lend me your ears. It is a distinct honor and privilege for me to stand here and share with you a few thoughts on the occasion. Now you say, the occasion, what is that? First of all, I greet all of you in the spirit of unity. Unity because we are all gathered here in this room, at this time, in this place, for one singular purpose. And what is that purpose? That purpose is to witness the swearing in of a new mayor for the city of Flint. We are here to see the transition of leadership from one administration to another. We are here to celebrate and commemorate the official act. We will watch that. We will witness that. That is something that we will not soon forget. We are here because we gathered here to see this and be able to tell our children about it and our grandchildren about it and to admonish them to pass it on to the generations that are to come. And what then can we expect after the swearing in? We can expect that there will be so therefore, we welcome change because we know that everything must change. Nothing stays the same. And one writer has adequately put it, the only thing in life that's constant is change. So ladies and gentlemen, let's open our arms to change. And now you say, well, what is this discourse on the occasion? What are you talking about? So glad you asked. We are here because we are commemorating a historic event. It is historic because it will be recorded in the archives of history for the city of Flint. And in the years to come, people will look back at that and say, in the year of 2015, Flint elected an African-American female to the office of mayor. It is a momentous occasion because it is of outstanding significance. And I said that earlier. It reiterates a message that we have been trying for years to get across to our African-American boys and girls. And that message is that you can become anything that you put your mind only if you're willing to work hard enough to make it come to pass. So that message we want to take home, we want to take back to school, to our boys and girls, and say, if she did it, you can too. Amen. And now before I take my seat, I want to make four main points. And that number one is the campaign is over. The people have spoken. A new mayor has been elected. So now all of what has been, what coulda, shoulda, woulda happened. And let's focus our eyes, our minds, and our strengths on what is and what can be. That's the way we want to look. That's point number one. Number two is what time is it? It's time for a new beginning. And when I say a new beginning, I say, we are starting again. I like the way that Ralph Waldo Emerson said it. He said, what lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters when compared to what lies within us. So now it is time for the real work to begin. It is time to roll up our sleeves, educate ourselves about the issues, get involved in the action, and become a part not of the problem, but of the solution. It is a time for unification, coming together to support, unite behind our mayor, support her, encourage her, and empower her to become the kind of leader we want to see. So I'm saying it is time for unification. And then the fourth and final point is that I acknowledge, and you will too, that there are some challenges. And of course, we will accept the challenges so we can feel the exhilaration of the victory. And that was said by General George Patton. We will accept those challenges that we're going to face so that we can feel the exhilaration of the victory. And remembering always in our hearts, because we come from a people who had to struggle, so there is without a struggle, there is no victory. So we are going to come together, to work together, to struggle together, to pray together, and make our city great. And then I would like to share with you just a recap of what we've said here today. What was the occasion? I'm so glad you asked. This occasion will go down in history as a historic event, a momentous occasion. And we clarified the purpose of why we're here and what we are about. And then we explored the four main points, answering that question, what time is it? Time for a new beginning. Then we issued a call to action. Dissertation, and I call it that because I'm saying to us that I issue a challenge to all of us that are in this room. As Dr. Weaver takes her open office, I admonish all of us to individually take silent and open to uphold her, to support her, and to help to make this city great. And so I say to you, in closing, that this challenge that I am issuing, if you don't remember anything else I said today, please remember the challenge. Because what really matters in the long run, because we live in a democracy, this task does not belong singularly to Dr. Weaver. It belongs to all of us. We all have an obligation to get in the fight and work and support and help. So I say to you that I hereby issue this challenge that we are going to remember, first of all, the words of Dr. Martin Luther King. We all can help because he said it so well when he said that if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, keep moving forward. So we're going to say to you today, that when you leave this room, when you leave this room, leave this room determined, with renewed determination, to keep Dr. Weaver and the city of Flint moving forward. And I thank you.
I give honor and praise for the opportunity to stand here today and be a part of this great, momentous occasion.
That's the NPR mic.
Okay.
It's this mic right here.
Which one is it? Oh, this one. Praise the Lord. Thank you. God bless you, Ms. Karen. Thank you so very much. I appreciate being here. Thank you. I give all honor to the master of ceremony, too, but just be reminded that comment you made that I worked in homicide. but he got a good funeral home he can go to. Moon. Smooches. Amen. It must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. Now I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you are a hero? And everything we like to be. You can fly higher than an eagle. 'Cause you are the wind beneath our wings. It might have been meant to go unnoticed, but we've got it all here in our hearts. We want you to know we know the truth. Of course we know it. We can be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you are a hero? And everything we like to be. And we could fly higher than an eagle. 'Cause you are the wind beneath our wings. Did you ever know that you are a hero? And everything we like to be. And you can fly higher than an eagle. 'Cause you are the wind beneath our wings. You are the wind beneath our wings. God bless you.
Thank you so very much, Minister. Minister, retired homicide detective, preacher, singer, Joanne Carrington. Thank you so very much for outstanding song. If you hadn't showed out so bad, I'd be crying. Dr. Muldrew, thank you so very much for the occasion and the challenge. I still have to stay on schedule, so, you know, I'm going to scrap it up from somewhere else. At this time, we will have the oath of office, which will be rendered by the Honorable Judge William Crawford, 68th District Court, who will be followed by Bishop Bernardale L. Jefferson, pastor of Faith Deliverance Center. That will be a prayer of unity. So we'll come in that order, and we will keep it moving because I still got to get some time back. Thank you.
Raise your right hand, please, and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Karen Weaver.
Do hereby solemnly swear and affirm.
Do hereby solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support and uphold.
That I will support and uphold.
The Constitution of the United States of America.
The Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of Mayor of the City of Flint.
Of Mayor of the City of Flint.
To which office I have been duly elected.
To which office I have been duly elected.
And which office I do not hold.
And which office I do not hold.
To the best of my abilities.
To the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Let me be the first to congratulate the first female mayor in the history of City of Flint.
And an honor and a privilege to stand before you today to pray a prayer of unity, not only for our mayor and the city of Flint, for the people of Genesee County in totality. Father, we come thanking you for your goodness and your mercy. We thank you for what our eyes have seen and our ears have heard. We thank you, Lord God, how you brought us together today. We thank you how you brought this city together. And we know that united we stand and divided we fall. God, we thank you for that person that you have put in office, Karen, Mayor Karen Weaver, to stand with the people, not against the people, not alone. Because this work cannot be done by herself. It will take us coming from the north, east, and west, from the south side, that we come together as one, as a unified body. For united we shall stand. And divided, we will not fall because we're not going to divide. We set aside disagreements. We set aside all grief. We come together on one accord. And that one accord is our city, that we might grow, that we might prosper, that we might be what we once was before, that we will be better than what we was, because we will stand together. We will fight together. We know she can't do it alone. We know that we're going to take our hands and apply them to good. We're going to work together. We're going to stand together. We're going to put our all in all. We're going to put our understanding. We're going to put our talent and we're going to work as one for the job. And when it's all said and done, it'll say, job well done, my good and faithful servants. God bless you. It's my prayer.
Bishop, thank you so very much for that unifying prayer. The mayor has always said, because she's sworn in, she is the mayor. The mayor has always said, that's right, she deserves all of that. She was going to be the mayor of and for all of the people. Praise the Lord that we have that kind of a mayor. At this time, we also want to thank you, Judge Crawford, for that wonderful ceremony that you rendered. Thank you. I still got to catch some time, so I'm gonna switch some stuff right here. Don't read your program, follow mine. Okay. At this time, I want Pastor Harris, who's going to pray for the city, who is the pastor of the Saints of God Church. I want Pastor Harris to come, but to be followed immediately by the ladies of the Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Zeta Beta Omega Chapter, and the Lynx of Flint area chapter. They will come in that order, then I'll come back and we'll be almost out of here. I almost got my time back. Come on, preacher.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and acknowledge you as the ultimate source of the many blessings that are manifested within our lives. We believe you have providentially and strategically placed us within this community to seek the common good of everyone. We pray that your blessings be upon our city and our newly installed mayor Dr. Karen Williams Weaver, may her appointment to what we believe to be a divine assignment facilitate a city government that will positively impact our entire city on every level. On the level of those who labor at City Hall, on the level of those who labor in churches and other religious bodies, on the level of those who are healthcare providers, on the level of business and economic development entities, on the level of educational institutions, on the level of law enforcement agencies, on the level of legal magistrates, on the level of individual family units and neighborhood organizations, on the level of philanthropic foundations. We pray that you would bring us together, and may we attain a stronger bond of partnership and collaboration geared towards no one in our community being left behind. And finally, we pray that this continued revival and reestablishment of the city of Flint will culminate in its control being returned to those who have been elected by the people and for the people. This is my prayer in the name of the one who died, that we might live.
Good afternoon. Mayor Dr. Karen Weaver, would you please stand? Mayor Dr. Karen Weaver, would you please stand? On behalf of the members of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Flint, Michigan, we congratulate you. We love you. We thank you. We honor you and we support you. As you join a long line of firsts, you're a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, the first black sorority, Greek letter organization in America. You're the daughter of a first. You married into a family of firsts, and now you've become a first. We thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, Flint, Michigan.
Good morning.
If my Link sisters would please stand. Oh, good afternoon, I'm sorry. This is such an exciting moment. My Link sisters, my connecting links, our arrow links, would you all please stand to join me on this day, November 9th, 1946, the Lynx Incorporated was founded by Margaret Hawkins and Sarah Scott Strickland to uplift the African American community. On this day, November 9th, 2015, Arrow Link, Dr. Karen Williams Weaver, has taken the oath of office and has been sworn in as the mayor of the city of Flint. This is truly an historic occasion. The Flint area Michigan chapter of the Lynx Incorporated congratulates our first female mayor, Madam Mayor Karen Williams Weaver. And our Arrow Link, Dr. Rex Weaver, our newly appointed first gentleman. The Flint area Michigan chapter brings the gifts of friendship and service. And we pledge our continued support to the greater Flint community and to the uplifting of this administration to do a great work. We present to you an engraved pen of inspiration and thank you for caring about Flint.
We certainly want to say thank you to the ladies of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority and the Lynx Incorporated. Rex, they finally acknowledge you, boy. First, I was going to try to work it out, you know what I'm saying? But thank you so much, Mrs. Stanley. We appreciate that. Again, I'm trying to get my minutes now. I'm almost in now. Now, she sent me a message about what to do, so that's what I'm trying to do. So don't worry about me. Don't get on me now, because it's her to do it. And let me just say this, because what I'm going to do now is try to fix this so I don't never have to get back up. She's very direct. She'll tell you exactly what she want, how she want it. Don't get your feelings hurt. Keep your big boy pants and dresses on, because that's how she operates. So, you know, I understand who you're dealing with. Help her out. Don't get offended. Just huck up and buck up and let's help her. As I prepare to close, the Bible says that the greatest among them shall be called servant. She is the number one servant in the city of Flint. At this time, since I don't have to come back up, she said she didn't want to get up at one time, I'm going to bring her pastor, the Reverend Dr. Byron C. Moore of the Vernon Chapel AME Church, who will pray for her commissioning. We will hear remarks from the mayor-elect, the mayor. Then we will have our own doctor, Henry Fuller, to come and give the benediction. There will be no other messages after that. There's something on here about something to eat. Where you going to feed them at? Come on. Where are we feeding them at, City Council? Is it downstairs? Oh, wait, that, all the way down? In the basement? First floor, after the mayor get, and the benediction. I'm sure he's going to bless the food. He that kind of guy. Everybody going to go downstairs and celebrate. Amen? Pastor Moore.
Amen. Madam Mayor, would you please stand? Amen. It was God who spoke to the elders at the Church of Antioch and said to them, "Separate me, Paul and Barnabas, for this work." And so now we come together to ask God and to affirm what God has done by separating you for the work of mayor of the great city of Flint. Father, we thank you and we praise you right now that whenever times of crisis have arisen, you've always put your hand on a servant and raised up someone who would follow your will, who would love your people, and who would listen to your command. In the spirit of Esther, who declared for such a time as this, we come now, O God, to declare that we hear your calling. We follow suit. We lift up her arms, O God, for she is not in this by herself, but inasmuch as you have called her and commissioned her to take the authority of the office of mayor, you've also called us and commissioned us to hold up her arms, to move this vision forward, that as the eyes of the world are upon this city, we will show them what godly unity looks like as we get behind this mayor and move your vision forward. We thank you right now for the anointing is on her life and the appointing is there on today. And we pray it all in the name of Jesus who died and rose for us. Let the whole city say amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of the city of Flint, Dr. Karen Walker.
Well, first, let me give glory and praise to God. And I cannot believe how many people are here this afternoon. Thank you all for coming. To my pastor, the Reverend Dr. Moore and his wife, Reverend Sharon, to my Vernon Chapel family, to all of the members of the clergy who were my first contact and whose counsel I sought before publicly making my announcement. If you all would just stand up for a minute, please. I am so happy to have you all here with me by my side. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. To the members, I'm going to turn for just a minute because I want to say to the members of the City Council and to all of the elected officials, to my family, my husband Rex, of 28 years. He's been my strongest supporter during this campaign, and to my children, Adrian, Alana is not here, she's at school, Doug, I need to thank you all for your patience and for your understanding, because you all gave a lot. To my sister, Helen, my sister-in-law, Lisa, Lynn can't be here today, my brother-in-laws, Jack is not here, but William is here, and to my cousins that are all here, and my friends that traveled here to be with me. And I do, you have to allow me to offer a special salute to my parents, the late Dr. T. Wendell Williams and Marion Coates Williams, and my late brother, T. Wendell Williams, Jr. And I know people have talked about it, but service has been a part of my family. It's been part of my family's DNA. My grandfather was an AME pastor. My father was one of the first African-American pediatricians and the first African-American elected to the Flint Board of Education. And my mother was the first African-American classroom teacher in the city of Flint. My sister Helen later followed in my father's footsteps and served as a member also of the Flint Board of Education. My late father and mother-in-law, Dr. Rex Weaver and Jackie Weaver, they were leaders in this community, and I don't know who didn't go and see Dr. Weaver over on Dewey Street, so I gotta tip my hat to them. They were leaders in the community. So you see that service for me has been an integral part of my life. It's not a job, but it is a calling. To my advisors, my volunteers, my contributors, you walked with me, you all made phone calls with me, you stayed up late at night, you gave me money, and you sat with me for all of those days and nights, and I will always, always be grateful to you. You all know who you are, you can wave your hands, you can stand up, do whatever you want to do. But I pledge to you to work hard every single day to give you a handsome return on your investment. And I have, there's some people whose names I do need to say. Some of them may be here, but there's Melissa Mays. There's Claire McClintock, Leanne Walters, and I think Councilman Mays might have been with that group too. And the concerned pastors who all stayed vigilant in the fight for clean, affordable water. And we thank them. Dr. Mona Hannah Atisha could not be here. She's the director of Hurley Medical Center, the pediatric residency program, and research was a critical factor in changing the course of events here related to the water crisis, so we need to give her a thank you. Raquel Thune, she's the director of programs of the Ruth Mott Foundation. The Ruth Mott Foundation announced last week that the north side of Flint, I'm gonna say that again, that the north side of Flint which has some of our most neglected neighborhoods, would be the primary target of its funding priorities. And that's a phenomenal commitment. And I look forward to partnering with them on this major investment in our neighborhoods, and that's just a start. So I want to personally thank the Ruth Mott Foundation. Mr. I hope, if I say your name wrong, forgive me, Mr. Tawab, the superintendent of Flint Community Schools, you have taken on an awesome challenge leading the education of our children. That's very important. And my administration will be a reliable partner. It will be a reliable partner with the educational systems, all of the educational institutions in our community. And I want to thank you for taking on this responsibility for looking out for our children's education. Thank you. Is Kay Schwartz here? Kay Schwartz is the director of the Flint Public Library and the residents of Flint. There you are. Hi, Kay. The residents of Flint once again demonstrated their wisdom and generosity by approving a critical millage last week. And my administration looks forward to working with you as we continue to showcase this resource, because that's a resource in our community. So thank you, Kay. So my journey, our journey, because that's what it is, it's our journey to this auspicious moment, began when a few prominent leaders in the community asked me to consider this demanding undertaking. After being actively involved in several political campaigns, several of them, I felt a need to explore some other avenues of service. And this exploration began about 18 months ago. And contrary to what some thought, it was not a whimsical decision. On March 21st, I stood before many of you here today at Vernon Chapel Church, and we launched what political pundits called a steep climb, an overmatched contest. And according to the experts, they said we were defeated before the votes were even cast. They underestimated us. We had no money. We had no statewide network. We had no behind-the-scenes benefactors, no plan, no experience. Let me say that again. No, I said no experience. That's what they said. But God. But God. So, friends, we stepped out on faith. Faith in ourselves, faith in each other, faith in our collective resolve to bring the needed change to give Flint residents the democracy that we deserve. In the book of Matthew, it speaks about faith the size of a mustard seed. Well, you know, and being able to move mountains. Well, on November 3rd, what did we see? We saw mustard seed faith in action. I wish I could sing. I wish I could sing, but I can't. But one of my favorite gospel hymns is "We've Come This Far by Faith," leaning on the Lord. And we trusted in His holy word, and He hasn't failed us yet. But faith carried us to this point. That's what happened. So, friends, this isn't a complex situation that we find ourselves in. In fact, it's quite simple. It's quite simple. On November 3rd, residents said in a loud, clear voice that they were sick and tired of poison water. They said they were sick and tired of high water bills. They said they were sick and tired of being undervalued and marginalized. you know, sick and tired of double talk and political speak. And they said to me over and over again that we want real change. That's what we want, real change. Not a reasonable facsimile, but real change. They said we want a new direction. They said we want to charter a new course. And so, my friends, I want to make it abundantly clear. I didn't knock on 100 doors, rise early every morning doing double duty as a political candidate and small business owner. I didn't attend countless churches and social functions to arrive at this moment of investiture, this sacred moment of commitment and reflection, this moment of historical importance. This moment, we celebrate a victory for all of Flint. For all of Flint. You know, I didn't, you didn't. We didn't work this hard to preside over the status quo. We want to reconnect Flint with democracy and home rule, just as we reconnected Flint back to Detroit water. That's what we want to do. We ran on a platform of change, a change in gender and a change in color. In the mayor's office, those are points of interest to the media and others. But let's be real. Let's be real. If it's a continuation of business as usual, then this is a hollow victory. To Governor Snyder, I want to state, as I did repeatedly on the campaign trail, I do not embrace the current governance model on a moral or political basis. I don't embrace it. I don't. Thank you. The hardworking citizens of Flint deserve a full voice in the operation of their governmental affairs. I understand that the wheels of government grind slowly. I get that. And I've said since this election that I'm not interested in radical changes in city government operations. Some of you supported me. Some of you didn't. But now, Dr. Muldrew, just like you said, it's time to come together as one. It's time to work together in trying to make our city be the best that it can be. And I'm looking forward to working with you guys. In the interim, I plan to work cooperatively with the city administrator. I plan to work with the city council and the transition advisory board. I understand that the governor and his advisors want to see a strategic game plan that reflects capacity and competence. I understand that. And my pledge is that a Weaver administration will demonstrate the capacity and political will necessary for self-governance. But the thing, I can't perform this responsibility, though. Not when I got one hand tied behind my back and a blindfold on. I can't do that. And that's not fair competition. You know, it's not. In the Bible, there's a compelling story of Nehemiah being dispatched as a political official to Jerusalem to repair and rebuild its walls and gates that had been torn down. Well, this scripture provides an uncanny metaphorical parallel to the challenges we face in Flint today. You know, our walls have been damaged, if not decimated. If not decimated. And so I ran on a platform to rebuild and restore the public trust in city government. And I take it as a personal charge to assure you that the commitments made by a Weaver administration will be fulfilled. To commence a process to assess and fix Flint's long-term financial challenges, to fix Flint's broken water system. The previous administration put the cost for this project at about $45 million, but scientists from Virginia Tech estimate a cost in excess of $1.2 billion. But whatever the final tally is, it's not in the city's coffers. And that's why I will immediately start discussions with Congressman Dan Kildee, Senators Debbie Stabenow and Gary Peters, our state legislative delegation, State Representatives Neely, Sheldon Neely, and Phelps, and State Senator Jim Ananick, to request a federal disaster declaration. And I said it before and I say it again, I'm gonna work to restore community policing in our city because it's a proven public strategy that works. The Ruth Mott Foundation provides an excellent platform for us to leverage other resources to rebuild Flint neighborhoods. I am committed to an approach that includes a mix of build, new build, rental, apartments, and aggressive rehabilitation. Economic development is an extremely important priority for my administration, and I'm committed to a balance of retention and attraction. Next week, I will issue a Weaver administration 100-day agenda. But I'm gonna give you one teaser. Citizen engagement will be a cornerstone. Thank you. Winston Churchill said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give." Being elected mayor of my hometown affords me an awesome opportunity to serve, and for that I thank you. I thank all of you. It will not be an easy undertaking. Expectations are high, and I ask all of you to stay engaged because I believe the best of Flint is yet to come. I just want to say thank you. Thank you to everybody. God bless all of you and God bless Flint.
God bless. As we get ready to journey from here, we do want to receive the benediction. I know it's a moment of jubilation, but let us at least respect the fact that we will leave here together, and it can mean much to this now mayor of the city of Flint. To all the persons that I should address, let me thank you. I say to you now, mayor, not mayor-elect, but mayor, that who knows whether or not that God has brought you forward for just such a time as this. This has not caught God by surprise, and thereby it is your moment of opportunity as the unfolding will of Almighty God. Let me say, as we get ready to give the closing moment of our gathering here today, that I know that we are all bewildered, we all stand in limbo, but I come to tell you today that God is able. And if we can but lift up our heads, march back to the challenges that are there, our God will direct and show us the way beyond this present moment. Let us pray. Father God, we come now as humble as we know how to come, and how thankful we are to you. We believe and know assuredly that this is the moment that you prepared us for. The many dangers that have brought us to this moment, the things that have left us shattered beyond known measure, we know that you're able to show us a way out. We pray now for this mayor, that even as she takes this challenge, that, Lord, you would give her the directive that you would have her lead, that the decision made would be in the behalf of your people all over this city, all over the county, and that now, Lord, you would give us strength to reach out in the areas of need and to make the tough decision and stand there with everlasting willingness to co-labor with all others that would bring it to be, crown her head with wisdom and knowledge and the supporters around, that they may not look selfishly, but look on the things that would be good according and for the people of God. Now, as we leave this moment, we ask your blessing upon the food that has been prepared for the nourishment of our bodies, that it may strengthen us, that we may serve you throughout this another day. We ask these by the name of our Lord Jesus the Christ. Amen, amen. And amen. Go to your own house.
God, okay. We've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in His holy word. He never failed.
Yeah, I'm trying to get my shot.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.